Hello from the shores of Lake Marion, the largest lake in South Carolina. We're here at Camp Bob Cooper looking at a great egret, Ardea alba. All right, this is one of our common wading birds in South Carolina. You'll notice this crook in his neck. He's got this long neck that is one of his adaptations in order to help him eat in shallow water. That long spear-like beak and that long neck, and you see that pronounced crook in it. He can curl that neck up in flight so that it's not flapping around. He's hunting now. He's got long black legs so that he can wade around in this shallow water, sometimes in vegetation like this, and sometimes just in water without vegetation. So there you can see how his white neck against that water background, it makes it pretty difficult to see him. So though he might not be camouflaged real great in the green foliage, he is in the white background of the water. The Great Egret is actually the symbol of the National Audubon Society. So it's an interesting fact about him. Of course, that's an organization that was created in order to protect birds from being killed for their feathers. These birds are another cool fact about them. They fly about 25 miles an hour, very slow but powerful flight, about two wing beats per second. The Great Egret. We're looking at a green heron here, all right? This is a unique experience here. This bird is very uncommon and just a very inconspicuous bird. He hides out, doesn't really show himself very often, so this is pretty cool. Green heron. He nests and roosts in trees, low trees over the water, and shrubs, forages along tree lines, streams, and ponds. Very, very small heron. Still considered one of our wading birds, but just a smaller one. Got short legs, stocky shape, short, broad wings. He's got a really, really explosive, sharp skew when he's flying. Very nervous bird. This is our, once again, green heron.